Hey buddy, do you have a laptop that is old and slow? Have you tried to install Windows or Linux and it didn't work? In this video, I will show you how you can install Chromium OS on your laptop. Chromium OS is just an open source version of Google's Chrome OS. The Chrome OS comes pre-installed when you buy a Chromebook. Just like Chrome and Chromium browser, Chromium OS is an open source version of Chrome OS. As Chromium OS is a very lightweight operating system when compared with Windows and Linux, on older machines it will work a lot faster and smoother. Also, if you're using Windows, then there are almost no viruses in Chromium OS. Note that this exact method will work if you are either installing on a PC or a laptop. So without wasting a second, let's get started. Now we need to download two things. First one is the Chromium OS itself, and then we also need to download a software called Etcher, which is a bootable USB creation software. So let's open your favorite internet browser. In this case, I'm opening Firefox Quantum. We won't be downloading the original version of Chromium OS as it won't run on our PC or laptop. We need to download a version provided by a company called Neverware. It is called Cloud Ready. Cloud Ready adds some extra drivers and kernel files to make the OS bootable for our PCs and laptops. But don't worry, this is totally free and completely safe. Popular schools and companies use this Cloud Ready Chromium OS, so let's head over to the Neverware website. And now there are different versions of Chromium OS made for different purposes by Cloud Ready. For this video, we'll be downloading the Home Edition as it is totally free to use personally. For home computers, this is the best option one can get. If you want to install this on a school, then there is also an education edition of Chromium OS. The link to this page is in the description. So just click the link and you should be at the Home Edition download page. There is a Windows USB creation tool by Cloud Ready, but as far as I have used, the download file is around 5 GB. And the tool downloads way too slow. Also, there is no rescue system, which means if you accidentally closed it, you have just wasted 5 GB of your internet. So I recommend you to download the compressed zip file manually. So scroll down and click on the appropriate buttons to download the required version. If your target PC or laptop is a 32-bit machine, then download the 32-bit version and vice versa. But if you download the 64-bit version and try to install it on a 32-bit machine, simply it is not going to boot. Once downloading the compressed zip has successfully completed, let's download the tool that I was talking about. The tool is called Etcher and is the best bootable USB creation tool I have ever seen. To download, let's open a new tab and navigate to Etcher's website. Also, there is a link to this website in the description. Here also, you have to download the Etcher according to your CPU architecture of the PC or laptop you're currently working. If you are going to install Chromium OS on the same machine you are creating bootable USB, then download the 64-bit version if you have downloaded 64-bit Chromium OS and vice versa. Hoping that you understood, let's continue. Click on the download button to start the download. The tool is approximately 50 megabytes. After the downloading has completed, it's time to install it. Launch the setup file as administrator. Press on I agree and the installation should start. As it will take some time, I have speed up the video. Once the installation has completed, Etcher should automatically launch. As we don't need it now, simply close it. Now we need to extract the downloaded zip file. I recommend you to use 7-zip for this purpose. Once completed, you should have this bin file. The zip file is heavily compressed. When I downloaded the zip file, the size was 2 GB approx. But now the bin file is around 5.5 GB, so make sure you check the MD5 checksum before installing. Now connect the USB pen drive you want to make bootable and launch Etcher. Here simply click on the button called Select Image and browse for the extracted bin file. Finally hit on the flash button to start flashing. The process took around 20 minutes to write and verify. I thought it would install pretty quickly as my USB was USB 3.0, but it did not. Once the flashing has completed, you should have something similar to this. Now close Etcher and unplug the USB stick. Now if you're installing on the same machine you created bootable USB, then turn it off. I recommend you to remove all the extra drives and plug in the USB stick. I apologize for the bad quality, but there is no way one can record a BIOS. The BIOS key is different for PCs and laptops, so find out your BIOS key. For most of the PCs, it's delete key, and for most of the laptops, it's either F1 or F2. Also, your BIOS might look like this or not, so head over to the boot section of your BIOS. Here, set the first boot device to USB or external device in my case. Now save the BIOS settings and reboot the laptop. Some BIOS programs will automatically reboot and some won't. As the video quality was crap, I have connected a monitor to my laptop. Now the PC or laptop should automatically boot from the USB instead of booting from your internal hard disk. Now wait for a couple of seconds to load the Chromium OS from the USB. Especially if you're using a USB 2.0 drive, then this might take a while. Once you're asked to sign in, click on the button called Browse as Guest at the bottom left corner. Now it should open a temporary session for you. Close the Chromium browser as we don't need it right now. Now this is where I should say sorry for zooming in insanely as the quality is the worst. But hoping you can read what's on the screen, click on the menu button named Install Cloud Ready and the installer should start. Here, click on the button called Install Cloud Ready to start the installation. There is a screen which my mouse malfunctioned at the right time and I clicked it away. It will basically show you a final prompt and ask you if you are sure about installing. This will delete everything from your hard disk and will freshly install Chromium OS. The installation took me another 20 minutes and once completed, it automatically booted into the hard disk. Now sign in with your Google credentials and you should be welcomed with a fresh clean install of Chromium OS. Within a short period of time, all your bookmarks, apps and extensions will be automatically installed. So you have successfully installed Chromium OS on a PC or laptop. The best thing I like about Chromium OS is how fast it turns on and shuts down. I have never seen an operating system turn off so quickly. So that was it for this video. Please like this video if you liked it and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this one but in a better quality. This is Listen Developer, signing off.